Good morning, I'm Ricky Pitman.
And I'm Joel Gamble. This is Good Morning Friendswood, 1981.
Iran said its forces at the battered oil refinery center of Abadan beat back Iraqi tank assaults Tuesday on the city's main gate at Bamance River Bridge, but added that Iraqi forces pressed the attack and hurled mortar barrages at the city. Iraq claimed 38 Iranians were killed in house-to-house fighting in the oil port of Karachmar, 10 miles to the north. In the 30th day of war, Iran claimed to have halted Iraqi tanks at the Bayrashar River Bridge, considered the gateway to Abadan. As to negotiations between the two countries of the members of the 40-nation Islamic Conference, said, quote, they're still talking to me and that means there's still a glimmer of hope, unquote.
Presidential candidate Ronald Reagan and President Carter agreed last Tuesday to hold a 90-minute-long nationally televised debate October 28th in Cleveland, Ohio. The debate is being sponsored by the League of Women Voters. The chairman of the League, Ruth Hinterfield, made the announcement after nearly 2 hours of discussions between strategists for the Republican and Democratic nominees. The long-sought debate will begin at 8:30 p.m. Houston time and will be divided into two segments. The first segment, four panelists will be permitted to ask follow-up questions to the original inquiries, and the candidates will be allowed a rebuttal. The second half, the candidates will be permitted rebuttals and also responses to their opponents' rebuttals. Each candidate will also be allowed time for a closing statement.
On October 10th and 11th, the speech tournament was held at Ross Sterling High School. Speech tournament is a competition between boys and girls from different schools. There are 33 boys and girls who went there from Friendswood Junior High. There were only two students that won. Mike Lippert, first place in Novice, Humorous, and Impromptu, and Jack Shelton, third place in Novice and Poetry.
Last week, the Pep Club was selling ornaments for football players and the Pep Club savings. This money went to banquets and the school. Pep Club is a school activity for girls only. We hope in the years to come that Pep Club will grow bigger and better.
Mark Goodman and Todd Green were at the sock hop last Thursday. They talked to some students and teachers for their comments about the sock hop.
Hi, I'm Todd Green here at the sock hop. Sock hop is one of the first rewards of the year today. Otherwise, the sock hop, you can go see the movie called Brian's Song. To get in the rewards, you must have less than 12 tickets and less than 3D halls. In a couple minutes, we'll be interviewing a couple teachers and people who have what they think the sock hop's like. David, have you ever been to one of these before?
No.
Michelle, would you like to come to another sock hop?
Well, not really, because nobody really did this.
Well, has anybody asked you so far?
One, but I said no. Would you like to come to this to another suck-up?
Yeah.
How about you?
Yeah.
What kind of music do you like? Rock, slow, buff?
I like rock.
Rock. Do you ever dance?
Yeah. I guess, you know, if they play more of a variety, they've already played one song twice.
Both.
Probably we'll have one more during the school year during our reward system. Yes.
Okay. What kind of things we have for music, like disc jockey or rec player? Do you have anything like that?
Yes, we'll probably have at our regular dances disc jockeys, at least two of them, and then we'll have a jukebox at the other two. But we'll continue to have our own music with our stereo system at our rewards.
Do you think the students should have more free time like this?
I think it's great for a reward once every 8 weeks or so. I think it's a good incentive to keep the discipline in the school and keep everybody working and striving for something. I think it's a great idea. More schools should have this, uh-huh.
Are the teachers here just for discipline or just to watch out for the kids?
I think for everyone's own safety, sometimes you can get out of hand. You may think you're having a good time, but you may be endangering somebody else. We're just here to watch you enjoy and make sure that nothing goes wrong.
Sports with Spencer Taylor.
We'll have junior high football scores and more right after this message.
America needs a responsible president, one who will do something about America's problems. For instance, inflation, the Iranian crisis, and military problems. Jimmy Carter is a good man for the job. His experience proves that. If Reagan is elected, he will go strictly to military force and forget his financial duties as a president. So come November 4th, let's re-elect President Carter.